You've called the president's tax plan in the past, quote, a con job and a scam. We've seen Walmart with big announcements this week, Apple now with a big announcement, other companies either raising wages or giving their employees money. Have you changed your opinion? And if not, should you?
Well, look, at when you think of the United States of America, you don't think of Walmart, you don't think of Apple, you think of the whole country. You think of every company, large and small. You think of every employee, large and small. It's the cover of Forbes, of Fortune, is United States of America, not Apple, not Walmart. So the story is yet to be told. And if
Walmart's the largest employer, if in fact,
as the president has promised, that every employee gets a $4,000 raise, let's see when that happens. So the proof is going to be in the pudding, not just isolated stories that can be put on the cover for a week or on a show for an afternoon, but the entire country and the ordinary workers in our country that see this promised $4,000 raise. I don't believe it's going to happen. I don't think most economists believe it's going to happen. And so, yeah, it's a nice story here for Apple, but, you know, ultimately, in December, Trump's Federal Communications Commission took net neutrality off of the books. And what did that do? Well, that created a culture for hundreds of thousands of app creators. Those are the job creators in the internet sector. And he took those off the books. So that is going to have a crippling effect upon the guarantee that app developers have to go to the capital markets in order to create those new jobs that'll dwarf anything that Apple itself is doing.
I like how you pivot to net neutrality, but I'm not done with this one yet.
Sure.
I mean, Walmart is the largest employer in the United States. And if you don't want to focus just on Walmart and you want to go more broadly, we just heard from the Federal Reserve, which said broadly, wages are up modestly in most areas, consumers are upbeat, and some think the unemployment rate could go down and have a three handle in front of it. That speaks more broadly. What's wrong with that?
Well, the unemployment rate had already plummeted from the near 10%, which George Bush handed over to Barack Obama. So what Donald Trump did, let's be honest, is he got to drive a brand new, one owner used Cadillac Economy. And so, yeah, he's dropped the unemployment rate a little bit, but ultimately the promise of this tax break is for a $4,000 increase in wages for all Americans, not a $1,000 one-time bonus to a small number of employees in a relatively small number of companies in the totality of the American economy. So you So I just don't want you engaging in a little bit of irrational exuberance here with a very small data set that doesn't represent the totality of the impact on the economy, because I think if you are, then you're going to be putting every nickel you got into $4,000 raises for all of Americans. And if you do that,
now I'm thinking about
then
the
you
campaign
could be
trail. If your colleagues are out there trying to tell people it's not as good as you think it is, which is an interesting message.
Well,
Senator, what do you make of the rallies that we've seen? We're above 26,000 now on the Dow Jones Industrial Average. Do you think that's irrational exuberance then? Is that what you're suggesting?
Well, look, at when George Bush left office in 2009, it was at 6,500. So it nearly tripled up to 18,000 under Barack Obama. So again, that's just a year ago where all this momentum had been created in the Obama administration. What this administration is doing is, in a very inefficient way, taking $1.5 trillion, creating a huge federal deficit addition, while inefficiently then allocating the capital which we have in our society, in our capitalistic system, giving, in many instances, too much to those who already have a lot and not enough to those who, if you gave them the money, they would spend it immediately. So it's almost like an upside down plan if you were trying to stimulate the economy. And so that's why they have to look to isolated pieces of information rather than the broad-based job creation and income increase, which was promised by the Trump administration. So I'm going to be a little bit of a skeptic here, doubt, as most economists do, that we're going to see that kind of an increase. And I'm also going to just dismiss a one-time increase by a company for a bonus because they don't want that $1,000 built into the base salary of the employees, because that would last year after year, and that would be too much of a commitment for a company to make because they're not certain that there is going to be that economic growth that you are referring to.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.